Now that the webcam software has been installed, it's time to verify that it works correctly and adjust the settings to improve its performance. First, we'll verify that it works correctly. Go up to the menu and pick Web Browser. When the window opens, we need to enter the URL for the webcam in the URL bar. Since the webcam software is currently running on the Raspberry Pi and this web browser is also running on the Raspberry Pi, I can use the word localhost to describe where we should get the web content from. In order to interact with the web server software, we also have to provide a port number that the software is running on. It's running on port 8080, so I'll type in a colon 8080 and hit enter. This loads up the initial screen of our web server. In order to view the video, I can click on MJPEG, and this will open up a view of the video. Although it doesn't show up in the screencast, I also have a small preview of this elsewhere on my screen. In my case, it's a little bit to the left of my web browser window. I have a small screen that's also showing the view from the webcam. Notice that inside the browser, the webcam looks relatively boring. That's because this is a really large image, and it's pointed at a small top that's spinning, but I'm only able to see the top of the image. Notice that the motion is also very, very jerky. That's partly because of the size of this image. In order to get a smoothly performing webcam, we need it to reduce the image, transfer much, much smaller pictures. So we're going to have to adjust the settings of our webcam software. In order to adjust those settings, first I'm going to close my web browser. And then I'm going to browse to and edit the settings. Go to the file manager and open it up. On the left-hand pane in the file manager, select the root directory. That's the very bottom folder that's just a forward slash. Within the root directory, select the etc. folder. Inside of the etc. folder, there are subfolders for many, many things. These are configurations for many of the features of the Raspberry Pi. Our webcam software's configuration is in the UV4L file, so I'm going to click on that. And I need to edit this file, but just double-clicking on it won't allow me to save changes. So I'm going to right-click on it and select Open With. This pops up a window that allows me to pick how I'm going to open this file. I'm going to select the Custom Command tab, and I'm going to type in sudo, S-U-D-O. That command allows us to read and write any file, among other things. And then I'm going to type in the name of the editor we'll be using, which is LeafPad. And then I'm going to hit the OK button. Now the configuration file opens up, and I'll be able to save my changes. There are really only three changes I want to make in this configuration file right now. So first, I'm going to scroll down. Below driver options, there's video overlay options. So that has something called no preview. If I want to disable that little preview window that popped up, the little window that was up here to the left of my web browser, I'm going to go ahead and type yes here. The two other options I'm going to change right now will allow us to edit this configuration file from within the web browser and also allow us to create passwords so when people access our webcam, they have to enter a password. So I will scroll down in the file. Until I get to the streaming server options section. In the streaming server options section, I'm going to look down, I'm going to find two options that I'm interested in. So there's a line here, server option equals user password. First, I'm going to go to the left-hand side, and I'm going to get rid of the space and the hash sign. The space and the hash sign essentially make that line be ignored. So there was no user password. And now I'm going to add in a user password. You should pick your own password, but for our demonstration today, I'm just going to say user pass. So that will create a password, so in order to see the camera, I will have to know this password. I'm also going to go down a couple lines further to where it has a config password. As I'm adjusting the parameters of my camera, I would prefer to be able to do that and save them without having to log into my Raspberry Pi. I would like to be able to change the settings remotely and test them out. So this will allow me to change the settings, edit this file from a web browser rather than having to log into my Raspberry Pi. So like before, I'll delete the characters on the left-hand side, the hash sign and the space. And like before, I'm going to pick a slightly different password. Again, you should pick your own password. For our demonstration today, I'm going to call it conf_pass. So I've got two separate passwords, a password for a user and a password to configure my Raspberry Pi. I'm now going to save this file. I'm going to go ahead and exit my file browser and my editor, and I'm going to reboot my Raspberry Pi so those changes take effect. So I'll go to the menu, I'm going to select shutdown, and I'm going to pick shutdown, and then I will turn off power and turn it back on. Okay, I've now restarted my Raspberry Pi, and now I'm going to adjust some of the configuration settings to try and improve the performance of our webcam. Again, I'm going to use the browser on the Raspberry Pi to access the webcam, so I'll start up the web browser from the menu. Then I'll access the webcam by typing in the URL, localhost:8080, and hit enter. Notice this time it's asking me for a password. At the moment, I want to be a user. I want to see what my webcam looks like. So the username is just user, and the password is the new password I created, user pass. And I'll hit the login button. And it takes us back to the screen we were at before. At this point, I'm going to experiment with some of the settings by clicking on the control panel. Later on, I'll come back and I'll click on configuration to actually change that configuration file to reflect the settings that I think work well for me. So once I click on configuration, it will take me to a separate page. And the separate page shows me several configuration options. I've experimented with this a little bit before, and I know that there are some options that work and some that don't, and some ways to improve the quality that are relatively consistent. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to decrease the width and height of the camera. Not all numbers can be used here, but I know that the combination of 640 and 480 is valid. I'm also going to try and decrease the quality of the images that are being streamed. So I'm going to decrease it from 85 to 45. I'm going to scroll down to the bottom of the page and hit apply. Now that these settings are in use, I'm going to test them out by looking at my live stream. And now we can see that my top is moving reasonably consistently. Okay, I'm pretty happy with those settings. So the last thing I want to do is actually change the configuration file so those settings are permanent. If I don't do this, when I reboot my Raspberry Pi, it will revert to the old, poorly performing settings. Okay, in order to change the settings, I'm going to go back to my main window, localhost:8080, and I'll select configuration. Now it's prompting me for the username and password to edit the configuration file. The username is config, and the password is the password we set for the configuration user. In my case, it was conf_pass. I hit the login button, and notice that it shows me essentially the exact same file I was editing earlier, and it even tells me exactly where it's at. I'm going to go ahead and try and find the settings for the image size, and notice right here, it already specifies width and height as 640 and 480, but notice that it has the hash mark and the space in front of it. I'm going to go ahead and delete both of those. When you see that in these configuration files, it means that it's currently ignoring that line, so it was not using 640 by 480. I'm also going to scroll down until I see the quality. And again, notice hash sign space. I'm going to get rid of that. So it wasn't actually using this quality setting at all. It was defaulting to 85, and I'm going to make it be 45 instead. I'm going to go ahead and hit the save button, and now my configuration has been permanently saved, and the next time I start up my Pi, it will work as I've just seen. The one last thing we need to test is we need to be sure that we'll be able to view this from another machine, not just from the Raspberry Pi itself. Soon we'll disconnect the monitor and the keyboard and the mouse, and we'll just have the Raspberry Pi running as a camera all by itself. In order to test it from another machine, I'm going to go up to the Wi-Fi icon, and notice when I do that, it shows me various pieces of information. The ones I'm particularly interested in are where it says WLAN 0 configured and gives some numbers. I'm going to be using those numbers, 10.0.1.11, to access the Raspberry Pi from another computer that's sharing the same access point as the Raspberry Pi. Okay, the last step of setting up our Raspberry Pi cam is testing it out from another computer. I've moved over to a different computer, a Macintosh, although this should work from any computer, and I've opened up a web browser. I'm now going to go to the address bar in my web browser and type in the IP address that corresponds to the Raspberry Pi. That was the number we saw listed up in the WLAN 0 configuration. So for me, that was 10.0.1.11. And then I'm going to type a colon and 8080, the port number that the webcam software is running on. When I hit enter, it'll pop up a window asking me for the username and the password. In this case, I just want to be a normal user watching the webcam, so the username will be user, and the password will be the password I configured for a user. In my case, I set it to be user pass. And I'll hit login, and notice that it brings up the list of all of my options. I'm going to go ahead and watch the video camera, and there's our top, moving relatively quickly.